Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to do an empties video and I don't have a lot of empties, but I do have quite a few makeup, so that is exciting. Yeah, I do an empties every single month, even though I don't finish a lot of items, but I really want to do these and just talk about them so my basket not full and we're not here all day. I know some people really want to see long empties videos and I do those sometimes, but this is real life. This is what I go through in a month. They are not completely full on the first of every month, but these are just what I finished that certain month. So I have two declutters this month. So I think I'm going to call these in the future empties and declutters, because I always declutter something every month, I have noticed. So that's just what I'm going to call it from now on. The two declutters I have this month is a mask and an After Sun lotion. Let's take this one. This is the Nivea Sun After Sun Moisture. I really, really enjoy this. It's not cruelty-free, so I can't buy it again though. But this is a really, really nice After Sun and it worked on my skin so well. But I have had this for like 2 years now. 3 years. So I'm not really comfortable at keeping it another year. So I'm just going to toss it and I'm really, really low, so it doesn't really matter. And I really want to use something that is cruelty free. So yeah, I need to find that. I don't know anything about sunscreens. This is a black head mask from Pure & Care. I really like this brand. It is cruelty free, so that is really nice, but I just don't like the peel off mask. I don't find them working that much either, so it is looking like this. As you can see, it is almost full. I have used it like just a few times and with my boyfriend and everything, but I just don't like this. Yeah, I have had it for quite a few years now, so maybe 2 years. So it says here it expires after 6 months. There you go. I don't want to put it on my face and break out from something that is supposed to prevent me breaking out. Tears. Finish the bar soap. This is something that I buy from Lidl, I think. It's like Aldi. Germany. Soft and creamy with moisturizer. I wash my brushes with this and it is just a bar soap. It's nice. I like it. I have like 3 of these left, so I buy them in a bulk set. So is it cruelty free though? I don't know. I hope they are. I have no idea if this is cruelty free. I hope so, because it's just really, really nice and it is inexpensive and my brushes are going to be clean with it. So that is what matters to me. Hopefully it is cruelty free. I'm not really sure actually. Something that is not cruelty-free, and that is my Nivea In Shower Body Lotion. I hate this is not cruelty-free. I love it so much. But yeah, it is not cruelty-free, which is a shame, because this is a perfect lazy person product, because you don't have to use body lotion after the shower. You can just apply it in the shower and just rinse it off immediately after you have applied it. It's just a really nice product. And this is the big bottle of 400 milliliters. So if you're not cruelty-free and you don't really care what you use and you want an in-shower body lotion, this one is good. I think you can get it with honey as well. I have used that one and that is really nice as well. I'm really sad about this. So if I want something like this again after my body lotions are done, I think, was it? I don't remember who it was, but I think I was recommended the Lush version of this, which is definitely more expensive. So yeah, it's just really, really nice product and I'm really irritated that I can't get that again. It's okay though, I live. I just have to don't be lazy about the body lotion. Then I finished the cleanser. This is the Skin Academy Pure Cleansing Facial Wash. In the beginning, I didn't really like this, but my skin did like this and it didn't break out from it. I wouldn't say I break out anymore from the new cleanser that I'm using, but my skin definitely didn't like the transition from this to the one I am using now. Yeah, so this is just really, really nice. This is for sensitive skin and it's fragrance free English. And it is paraben free and it is cruelty free. As you can see, there's a small bunny. It's just really, really nice cleanser, and it's not really expensive at all, so it is really nice, and I will go back to it when I need a new one, I think. It's like a gel, and then it, I wouldn't say it foams up, but it becomes like the consistency of a cleansing milk. So I wouldn't say it foams up, but it definitely changed. Yeah, it's really, really nice. We have a few makeup bits in here because I do keep them separate, so yeah, I just do that. I don't know why. Okay, let's see. I have 5 makeup empties this month and I'm pretty excited about it. I have finished my W7 The Queen of Brows brow gel. This is a really, really nice brow gel. It is a dark one. I think it is quite similar to the Essence one, because it also has a small brush right here. And yeah, it's also like the Gimme Brow from Benefit, just cruelty free. It has 8 milliliters, and that is quite a big brow gel. I know it comes out right here, but it's really dry when you try to apply it, and there is not much on the brush, and I'm not going to take the stopper out of this because that is going to be a mess when it is a brow gel. No thank you. I have a mascara from W7 as well. It is the Very Vegan mascara. This is a really, really nice mascara, and I really liked it layered with another one that I'm using from Noble Nordic. So yeah, this is a really, really nice one. Even though I don't like the brush, the mascara itself with the brush is really nice. This is a natural haired bristle brush thingy. I like the plastic brushes more because I think they give more volume to my lashes, but this is lengthening and volumizing, and yeah, it's really nice even though the brush is really boring and standard. But the mascara is really nice, but this is flaky now, so I can't use it anymore, and I have been using it for like 4 months. I switch out my mascaras between 3 and 4 months depending on if it is flaky. And I don't really like to buy expensive mascaras because I switch them out that often. I have my Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Concealer. I really, really like this stuff. You go through it quite fast, but that is because it only has 4 grams of product, which is not really a lot for a concealer. I have this in C1. I know a lot of people with fair skin tone goes like C3 or something, but I'm white as a paper and pale as a ghost. I need the lightest shade as you can get, and this is the lightest shade if you're not going to go with the white one. I really like this product. It is not full coverage, but it is enough coverage for me to feel alright and covered under my eyes. I already have a new one of these, and that I am saving for the winter time because this is perfect for me in the winter. And as you can see, it's a nice highlight shade for me. It's not this pale under my eyes though. I have a lip liner. I'm really excited about this one. This is the W7 Lip Twister in Champagne. I have a lot of W7 makeup empties this month. I didn't realize. This lip twister was in my Harry Potter project pan. Yes, it is completely gone. It is a beautiful nude color. It's not a pale nude, so it's on the darker side, but it's really, really nice. And these lip twisters are so nice because they are twisters. Is in the name, and if you want to, they have a sharpener in the end. I don't really use them because I fill in my whole lip and I don't really need an extremely sharp line through the edges, but if you really like that, you have the option. I can go through a lip liner in like 3 months if I use it every single day, maybe 2 months actually. You can go through them quite fast if you use them every single day and fill out the whole lip. I have quite big lips, so maybe that helps a little bit, but I really, really like these. I have a few in my collection still, so I'm going to use those up before I buy a new one. I really like this shade Champagne, and fortunately I have another one in my collection, so I'm not going to miss it just yet, even though I'm planning another lip liner. The last item that I am going to talk about is my W7 Strobe & Go Strobing Stick. I finished the highlighter. It's a cream highlighter. So excited about this. Let me try to swatch it. It is a beautiful shade. It's a perfect light champagne-y highlighter. Beautiful. I love it. I miss it so much. I'm panning the pink version right now and it's really not the same. Yeah, I really, really like this stuff, and it is a spoiler for my graveyard project pan, which I have one month left in. And yeah, but if you saw the last update for that project, you would know I would have finished it. But yeah, here we are. I'm excited. And one less highlighter in my collection, which is a huge deal for my numbers in my inventory. So I'm really, really excited about this. Let's end on a high note. That's everything for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, give it a like, subscribe down below, and I'm going to go before the sun comes in. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. I am doing these empties every single month, as I said in the beginning of the video. Even though I don't have a lot, they're quite exciting, I think. And yeah, I'm still on the... I need to find a dupe for this product that is cruelty-free. But yeah, fortunately, W7 is cruelty-free, so I can buy this again if I want to. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and until my next one, please take care.